hanging out here on BRGY. Gaya nga ng sinabi ko kanina, parang may niluluto dito sa BRGY ngayon. Ano kaya yun? Dito sa BRGY, we believe that good food tastes even better when shared with long-lasting friends. Kaya ngayon, isang dish na may long-lasting sarap ang isha-share sa atin ng isang world-class cook based in San Francisco, California. Sama-sama tayong matuto at matakam here on Tasteful Secrets.
So typically in barbecue sauce, we use normal ketchup that you find here in America, as well as some sort of like strong vinegar, maybe like an apple cider vinegar. So the way that I thought of it is, why don't we just substitute both of them? And it came out wonderfully. It brought out the sweetness, it brought out the acidity of both aspects that I like about the original ingredients, but the substitutions were incredible. They both bring brightness to the dish, as well as something that's distinct and homey as well. My name's Monique Faves. I'm a Filipino-American chef here in the Bay Area. My parents are both Filipino. My husband is French, so my family and I have like this French-Filipino-American background. I was really lucky when I was little. I knew exactly what I wanted to be, and that was a chef. I knew straight on that I loved food. When my grandpa and my father taught me how to cook, we didn't use any recipes. It was all from memory. So what I learned most of from my early childhood was learning how to taste. And that was very special for me, and it carried on throughout my career, working in some of the greatest restaurants in the world. I actually met my husband, Paul, in Copenhagen. We worked at Geranium, which is a 3-Michelin-star restaurant in Denmark. And it's really special because it's such a unique place, but it's where we met and it's where we fell in love. And that kind of jump-started my career in Paris as well as New York. When the pandemic happened, the workplaces we had, we were furloughed. We decided to sell bread out of our house just to not survive, but to actually help the community around us actually get some accessibility to great food, great bread, because the grocery stores were completely empty, and that was something very unexpected. So to help the community, we started baking pastries and bread out of our house. It grew into an entire menu, and we decided to just ride the wave. So Tarts the Faves is growing, and it's expanding faster than we thought. So we're finally going to open up a brick and mortar in Oakland that will sell retail, as well as all of our production will come out of that space. So very excited for that. For today, I'm making lamb riblets with two secret ingredients that I'm very excited to show you today. It's going to add some pop and some acidity as well. All right, let's get started. So first we have to prepare the lamb. That's the thing that takes the longest. Okay, so we have a beautiful rack of lamb. We call this like a Denver style lamb. It's almost part of the breast. And if you're confused, you can go to the local butcher shop and ask for spare rib type of lamb ribs and they will give that to you. So these are just the riblets that I make sure that it is high quality. There's no drying out of everything. Everything's pretty moist, but it's not like wet or bloody. Okay, so if you see here, there's all this fat, there's like this sinew here. So you can remove it or not. I choose not to remove too much. So you just follow the lines where they are. The sinew kind of makes everything a little bit tough, but you want to keep some fat on there. That way everything's super moist. And now it's time to do the rub. So first I have this aluminum foil. I usually like to season on this. That way everything's nice and clean. We're going to be using freshly cracked black pepper. And we're going to do this on both sides. Okay, so this is sea salt. I love this. I just like the taste of sea salt. It's more clean as well. So you kind of want to go heavy. When you do salt, it looks like a lot, but it's really not. And then we also have Aleppo pepper. Make sure the seasoning is nice and even. We're going to be using molongai leaves. This is it in its powder form. It's dried and it's almost bitter and grassy in a way. And I love the taste of this, how it comes through the meat and the lamb. Usually what I'm using this for when I grew up was, you know, we braise it in soups or stews or things like that. But now in California, they're using it as a superfood in lattes, maybe smoothies. It has so many antioxidants, just a beautiful green color itself. After that, everything's pretty much seasoned. So what we need to do is steam this. We need to tighten it up, make sure everything's wrapped correctly, and that way no steam comes out. Make sure you flatten everything out, and that's it. All right, so now we just need to place this on a baking sheet tray, and we're gonna place this in the oven at 425 degrees Fahrenheit for about an hour to an hour and a half. All right, next we are going to make our barbecue sauce for the lamb ribs. First, we're going to use molasses, and then here we have coconut sugar, or you can use palm sugar as well. We also have ground mustard. This gives it a little bit of earthiness. And then we're also going to put some salt here. So the secret ingredients here, we're going to be using UFC banana ketchup. We're using this instead of regular ketchup. It gives it more sweetness and just a little bit more tang for me. Next, we'll be using Datu Petit premium cane vinegar, just a little bit to give it that acidity that all barbecue sauces need. All right, so let's transfer this to the stove and let's get this cooking.
Let's turn this on to about medium high heat.
And once this reaches a boil, we're gonna whisk this constantly and then turn it down once it reaches a boil. So you can see this nice brightness from the banana ketchup, as well as the darkness from the molasses and the seasonings from the salt. And basically what happens is it all needs to reduce, maybe by half, until it gets really nice and thick. All right, so let's prepare the final touches for the lamb riblets. We're using herbs that you can find in your garden. You can use whatever you find. There's some fresh thyme. Then we also have sage. So just take these small leaves whole, and we're gonna chop these up all together. These herbs are very strong, so you don't need very much. Here we have our rosemary. There's some beautiful sage here. Then we have some thyme flowers here. And then afterwards, we'll also use the molongai leaves again. Now we're just gonna chop these up. Then season it with a little bit of sea salt. Perfect. All right, so let's look at our barbecue sauce. It looks great, nicely reduced. I think we're ready to go. And let's check on the ribs. This has been going for about at least an hour and a half. I'm just gonna place this on the cutting board and check if everything's done. You can see the steam come out. And the way to know that this is done is if you can wiggle the bones out, just like so. And that's how you know it's tender and it's ready to go. So we will transfer the lamb ribs onto the cutting board carefully. So now we will turn this, okay? Grab a basting brush and start painting. Be liberal on this. So you can smell the vinegar on this dish. It's really bright. It's really in your face once it comes out of the oven. The spices and the Aleppo pepper really come out. See this shine? That's because of the banana ketchup. The banana ketchup really makes a shine through this glaze. You can see how nicely reduced it is. And it just gives it a nice pop. Okay, so let's sprinkle some of our Roman herbs. Right, let's start plating. For our barbecue lamb riblets, we will need one rack of lamb riblets. For the Roman herbs, sage, dried molongai leaves, oregano, rosemary, thyme, and seasonal edible flowers. For the barbecue sauce, we'll need Datu Petit cane vinegar, UFC banana ketchup, palm sugar or coconut sugar, molasses, ground mustard, and freshly ground black pepper. We put a Filipino twist to this dish by using molungay leaves, as well as the banana ketchup and the vinegar as well. The molungay leaves really put like a grassy note to the lamb ribs, almost like matcha, bitter in a way, but sweet as well. The banana ketchup is very sweet, as well as the acidity from the vinegar really makes this dish pop. So here you have our barbecued lamb riblets with garden herbs. The lamb riblets turned out great. They have the caramel color that I wanted from the barbecue sauce and really the brightness from the garden herbs itself. I had so much fun doing this. I can't wait for next time. I'm going to be whipping up something that your kids are gonna love. My kids love it, and I'm sure yours will too.
Grabe ang mouth-watering naman ng niluto ni Chef Monique na lamb barbecue ribs. Abot ang sarap to the bones! Sa tulong ng kanyang secret sauce, nakagawa siya ng dish with long-lasting sarap na ma-enjoy ng buong pamilya. And as proven by Chef Monique, huling-huli mo na ang bawat panlasa dahil masarap, masaya sa Nutriasia. For more tasteful secrets, abangan ang iba pang Global Pinoys na magpapatakam sa atin in the coming weeks. Masarap, masaya, sasaya sa BRGY with Nutriasia. At kung may na-miss kayong episode ng BRGY, pwedeng-pwede nyo yan mabalikan sa iWantTFC app anytime, anywhere. Just download the iWantTFC app via Google Play Store for Android users and Apple App Store for iPhone users. Or visit iwanttfc.com and watch your favorite Kapamilya shows for free. Once again, this has been Shania Gomez, and I'll see you guys again next time only here on your favorite global hangout. Here on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you, BRGY. Hola, hey, my boy.